Hi, today we're going to speak about complaining as a way of life. Why do we do that always? I'm going to talk about a few instances, again, personally, that I've witnessed. And I want you to see if you resonate with something similar in whichever line. We all went out once on a family dinner. It was a wedding anniversary or something like that, some reason to celebrate, quite a few years ago. Beautiful meal, we all enjoyed the food, we had a great time. There were some at least 10-12 of us. In the middle, we asked for a little rice for a child. They brought the rice, the child enjoyed it. When the bill came, we looked at the bill and they had actually missed out an item, which was worth a few hundreds, which is alright, we told them. They corrected the bill, and when they sent us the new bill, when we looked at it, it had that new item that they had missed, plus another paltry 40 rupees for the rice that they had served for the little child. 40 rupees doesn't make a difference, not to the restaurant, not to us. But it did bother someone, one of the hosts. And it vitiated the entire atmosphere for the next 20-25 minutes. Was it worth it? We all went there to have a good time, to enjoy ourselves. But somewhere, something went wrong. Another case. An elderly couple, they have an only son who's married, got his own family, and he's moved on to another house far away. Naturally, the parents pine for the child. They keep calling him regularly, you don't come and see us, you don't visit us, just that every day, keep complaining. Why do other people have children who love them, but my child doesn't love me? The complaints just go on, leading to anxiety and absolutely going crazy and going into depression. We had some 3 or 4 conversations with her. Life changed. She quieted down. But what happened previously? She would keep complaining to him, asking him, please come back, come home, visit me. And he would say, look here, I'm not a psychiatrist, I'm not a doctor. Not realizing he is actually the medicine that she needed. But when she calmed down and saw things in a different light after the conversations we had, within 2 months or so, he came with his family and stayed at her place. After another month or so, again he came and spent the weekend over there. What changed? Everything was still the same, only she changed. The problem is, the way we see the problem is the problem. If we choose to look at it in a different light, from a different perspective, things can change. Another case with my own personal life. I'm largely a person who doesn't get angry. But road rage used to always trouble me. Why? Because I have a rationale. If you jump the lights, you can kill somebody. You can hurt somebody. So I would say, no, that is unacceptable. And once I got into a road rage, there was a fight. It was his fault. We almost got into fisticuffs. And something changed. I said I could only have been with this person for 0.5 seconds, just forgotten the whole thing and moved on. But I chose to engage with the person. It lasted maybe half an hour. If we had got hurt badly, it would have been a police case and maybe we would have spent a few days. Why do I need to make that 0.5 second interaction where I could just bypass the person and make it into a few days affair? Many of us get into this. The mind is nothing but a traffic of your thoughts. We need to choose our route carefully. Saina Nehwal and Roger Federer, what is common amongst them? Both are experts in their field. They both practiced 14 to 18 hours daily to get to where they are. Many of us are like them, but champions in complaining. We complain most of the day. People keep complaining about their neighbors, their spouses, their in-laws, their kids, their siblings. Modi, Kejriwal, Mamata Didi, I mean someone or the other, they keep abusing them. Why? Where does it get you? Let me tell you, none of the politicians really care if something happens to you or not. They're busy in their own worlds, doing what they do best. But we get caught into fighting with you, telling you he's right, he's great, she's great. Where does it get us? You and me fighting with each other. You and me getting anxious, not being able to sleep well at night, Is it worth it spoiling our social relationship, you know, our peace of mind, for somebody else who doesn't care? I have known people who've been complaining about their jobs, about their bosses, for the last 15-20 years. A job is where you work and spend half your life. What is the use if you're always complaining and sad and anxious about what you're doing half of your life? You think it's only going to be limited to work? Of course it's not going to be limited to work. It'll also reflect at home, and you'll have a terrible atmosphere at home too. Many of the people who see this video also will say, my God, what is he talking about? Our issues are different. They're terrible. What is he talking about? Of course we have to complain. It is about you and the people who are surrounding you, who you love or who love you. If you want to introspect, if you want to make a shift, it is not for me that I am making this video. I want you to reflect on what we're talking about only. I'd like most of us to begin the day with an I get to attitude rather than I have to attitude. Meaning, I get to go to work. Wow! I get to be busy. Wow! Rather than I have to go to work. I have a busy day today. Most of the time we see stress where there are opportunities. We often dress our opportunities as stress, when in fact they are blessings. People get angry with each other and keep getting upset. We beat people in arguments. We are very happy when they say sorry. But if your source of happiness comes from someone who does this or says this to you, then your source of happiness is very unstable, because it's not coming from within you. Someone says something nasty to you, and it is because there is some nastiness within them. If you were someone in love, you would only see love coming out of you. And if you look within, there will probably be a relationship problem, a financial problem, a health issue of themselves, the loved ones, some anger, frustration, guilt. We don't know what it is. What they need is your love. What they need is your compassion, or maybe your distance. When people are upset and angry and they are painful and they are hurting, they shut people out because they overthink, they trust less. That is why they need your love. The truth is, we simply cannot keep investing in our neuroses, our dramas, our resentments, our anger, and still think we have a space of love within. Are you living a rich life by living in gratitude, or in poverty by complaining for what you don't have? Every word you speak or write advertises your wisdom or your ignorance. It doesn't matter what others do. It matters what you do. Let's take a sample size of about 250 people, a WhatsApp group. You will always find anywhere between 2 to 5 people who are always finding some reason or the other to complain about something. And they will be righteous about everything. There is a very good rationale, a very good excuse why they are complaining, not realizing how they're affecting the lives of so many people around them. They are upset. They do not realize when they get upset, when they get angry, when they complain, it changes the dynamics within their body. Various diseases are creeping in, be it blood pressure, be it stress, be it anxiety, and then the associated problems. How many people do you know who've been given an award for just being critical, for just being complaining all the time? Whose bust have they ever made? Do you know of anyone? You never get an award for just complaining. You make life hell for your family, for your friends, for your colleagues, for your neighbors, for the world at large. But that is not what is my concern. My concern is, think about yourself if you can't think about anybody else. You are making life hell for yourself because diseases are creeping in. That becomes your default setting, so even you don't know
So are you someone who is always complaining? And if you are, you will always be anxious, agitated, and looking for problems as a problem seeker all your life? Or are you someone who the problem was a solution finder, a solution seeker? Then there will be a different attitude, and you will always be seeking peace, solutions for problems. And that is where your dynamics with people changes in either state. So I want you to think about this. Am I like this? Your thoughts, with the way you think, define your behavior. Your behavior defines your attitude. Your attitude defines your habits. Your habits define your personality. And your personality actually defines your future. Change your thoughts to change your destiny. Thank you.